Hello guys, welcome to Etrix Solution. In the last video, we have seen the logical explanation of the multiplexer and the designing of 2x1 and 4x1 multiplexer. In this video, we are going to discuss about the multiplexer tree. So let us first understand what is the multiplexer tree. So suppose you have many numbers of 2x1 multiplexer and you want a 4x1 multiplexer for some particular application. So you can design 4x1 multiplexer with the help of 2x1 multiplexers. So the multiplexer tree is the concept of designing of higher order of multiplexer using lower order of multiplexers. For example, we can design a 4x1 multiplexer using 2x1 multiplexers. Similarly, we can design 8x1 multiplexer using 4x1 multiplexers, and we can design 8x1 multiplexer using 2x1 multiplexers also. So let us first see the designing of 4x1 multiplexer using 2x1 multiplexer. So as we all know that the 4x1 multiplexer is a multiplexer which have the input data lines are 4 and the output is 1 only, and 2 selection lines are required to control the 4 input data lines. And this is the block diagram of a 4x1 multiplexer, in which D0, D1, D2, D3 are 4 input data lines, S0, S1 are the selection lines and Y is the output. So if I want to design this 4x1 multiplexer using the 2x1 multiplexers only, then let us first take a 2x1 multiplexer. So it is a 2x1 multiplexer having D0, D1 as the input, S is the selection line and Y1 is the output. Since this multiplexer have 2 inputs only, and in order to obtain the 4 inputs, we have to use one more 2x1 multiplexer in parallel with the multiplexer 1. Here you can see that the selection line of both the multiplexer 1 and multiplexer 2 are common and represented by S. So now we have the 4 inputs as per our requirement, but this circuit will give you the 2 outputs, Y1 and Y2, and 4x1 multiplexer having only single output. So to combine these 2 output, we can use one more 2x1 multiplexer and connect the output of multiplexer 1 and multiplexer 2 to the input of the multiplexer 3. So combinedly, you have a single output represented by Y3. So this is the complete designing of a 4x1 multiplexer using 3 2x1 multiplexer, in which you can see that you have the 4 inputs. D0, D1 inputs are from the multiplexer 1 and D2, D3 inputs are from the multiplexer 2. And you have the 2 selection lines, S0 and S1. The S0 selection line is common selection line from multiplexer 1 and multiplexer 2, and S1 selection line is the selection line of multiplexer 3. And a single output Y, which is the output of a 4x1 multiplexer. So in this way, you can design a 4x1 multiplexer using 3 2x1 multiplexers. You can verify the operation of this multiplexer tree with the help of truth table. So this is the truth table of a 4x1 multiplexer, in which you can see there are 2 selection line, and the 2 selection line can have 4 binary combination, and for each combination a particular data input line is selected to the output. So let us apply these combination to this multiplexer tree and let us see whether the output is equivalent to this truth table or not. So let us first connect the 0-0 combination at the selection line of this multiplexer tree. So let us connect एस जीरो विद जीरो एंड एस वन विद जीरो. सो देयरफॉर दिस सिलेक्शन लाइन हैविंग द वैल्यू जीरो एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस जीरो द आउटपुट ऑफ मल्टीप्लेक्सर वन इज द डेटा इनपुट डी जीरो एंड सिमिलरली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सिलेक्शन लाइन जीरो द आउटपुट ऑफ द मल्टीप्लेक्सर टू विल बी द डेटा लाइन D2. Now, the value of the selection line of multiplexer 3 is also 0. Therefore, this D0 will be selected at the output. And you can see there is a direct connection between the D0 and the output. Therefore, the final output will be D0. So you can see for the 0-0 combination, the final output will be D0 as per the truth table. Similarly, we can check for the other combinations also. So let us connect the second binary combination in which the S1 is 0 and S0 is 1. We are talking about this combination. So when this S0 selection line is 1, so because of this one, the output of the multiplexer 1 is connected to D1 and the output of the multiplexer 2 is connected to D3. And because the selection line of multiplexer 3 is 0, the Y3 is connected to the D0. So therefore, you can see that D1 input is connected directly to the output. Therefore, we will have D1 at the output, as you can see in the truth table also. Similarly, we can check for the other combinations. So we can skip this combination 1-0 and let us take the combination 1-1 directly. So if I connect S0 and S1 with binary combination 1-1, so this selection line is 1. Therefore, the output Y1 is connected to D1 and the output Y2 is connected to D3. And because the selection line of the multiplexer 3 is also 1, therefore the output Y3 is connected to this D1. And you can see that the input data line D3 is connected to the output through this path. Therefore, the output Y is equal to D3, as you can see in the truth table also. So in this way, you can verify this multiplexer tree and you can design a 4x1 multiplexer using 2x1 multiplexer. And we can see here that 2x1 multiplexers are required to implement 4x1 multiplexer. So this is all about the designing of multiplexer tree. I hope you are very well acquainted with the multiplexer tree designing. Thank you for watching this video and see you in the next video.